relaxing, chilled kind of piece, just to open us up. Hello, everybody. I've got my microphone a bit too loud there. There we go. Yeah, Trevor here for Alan's Music Centre live on YouTube on Monday. We're on the 23rd of August. The summer is flying by. And as you may have noticed, I am actually flying solo today. It's just me today. Tom is on the van doing delivery, so he may be watching. So hi, Tom, if you are watching. And it's good to be here again. And this, finally, we're with here with a Wersi OAX 1. We've been waiting a while to be able to do a Q&A on the Wersi organs, and we finally have one here, which is really good and very exciting. We've set up the screen so that we can see it on the other camera. We experimented with the idea of using the direct feed from the Wersi, because we can do that because it's a computer. But of course, we realised that unless we get a mouse and things, we can't actually point to the things that we want people to look at. So we're going to experiment with just pointing the camera at the screen, just for the time being, or for today anyway, see how that goes. And we have lots and lots of people in the chat. Wow. So it's a busy morning. Morning, Alf. Yes, morning, Trevor. Don't forget my activations on Thursday. Yes. Well, they will all be done. Yes, no problem at all. John Sinkovitz, good morning, Trevor. Hope you had a great weekend. I liked your two comparison videos you did. Did you get my email? Oh, I'll have to check that, John. Had a very busy weekend. You may notice I have a bit of a gruff voice this morning because I did lots of screaming yesterday. We went to a theme park, a local theme park, and I have a six-year-old girl you may know about, who is a bit of an adrenaline drunkie, and very, very gung-ho, and wanted to go on all the thrill rides. Now, unfortunately, or fortunately for me anyway, there were a few of them that she wasn't able to go on because she's not tall enough. But the ones that she wanted to go on, she's at that in-between age where she has to go on with an adult. So I ended up going on the roller coaster about six times, and down the log plume, and down the water splash, and I did a lot of screaming. So if my voice is a bit hoarse, that's because of my screaming yesterday. I did a lot of involuntary screaming. I always thought the people screamed on roller coasters just to have fun, but no, I was screaming out of terror. And she made me do that roller coaster six times. I mean, I am the best dad in the world. Anyway. Yeah, thank you, John. So I will have a look, John, for your email. Yeah, if people don't know, aren't members of Patreon, we've started a new little idea that came from a question of a Patreon, whereby we're looking at all the difference between different models. So we've been doing Larry organs, we're going to be going to the Ringways, we're going to do the Wersis. Just little videos highlighting what the difference is between different models in the range, and it's proved to be very, very popular. So yeah, we really shall do more of those. John Bradley, hello everyone. I hope you're all well. I'm looking forward to today's entertainment. I'm having some problems at the caravan site with the internet. Hope it doesn't let me down. Oh, keep fingers crossed for you, John. Yes, it's always the problem when you're out and about like that. Neville Jolly, good morning, Trevor. Everyone, question, please. Oh, question. I don't know whether a round of applause is on here. Oh, that's not it. That's not it.
Bang! 1, 2, 3, 4.
None of them are a round of applause. Oh, well. Neville had a question. What's the safest way to clear the problem? Question, please. If the organ freezes, which is the safest way to clear the problem without switching off at the mains? Thank you. Yes, so that's a very good question, Neville. So as we've mentioned no end of times before, the Wersi organs are based around the Windows computer, and it's doing lots of clever things to make it be a Wersi organ. And occasionally the computer can get itself a bit confused and decide that I'm not going to talk to you anymore and just lock up and go, nope, can't take any more, nope, I've had enough. And when it does that, there doesn't seem to be a way of turning off the organ, because like most computers, the way you turn this off is not by flicking a switch, it's by telling it to go turn off. You have to instruct it to shut itself down properly. So if the organ has freezed and it's going, I'm not going to talk to anybody, I don't like anybody anymore, no. There doesn't seem to be a way of actually turning it off, unless Neville said you just pull the plug out in the mains. There is actually a way that you can do what we call an emergency shutdown on the organ, and that's by using the actual power switch, which is over here on the right-hand side. So the power switch that you normally use to press once to turn the organ off and on. If the organ has locked on, and you can't switch it off, it's not talking to you anymore. If you hold down the power switch for, I think it's 20 seconds, it will override the computer and shut it down anyway. And that will have the equivalent of shutting off the power to it, and then we'll get rid of it. Now, when next time you turn it on, Windows will be a bit cross with you. It'll be like, oh, well, what are you doing turning me off without shutting me down properly? I'm not entirely happy about that. and so it may say, you know, I'm having to just make myself, sort myself out, as it were. And it's normally, once you've had an emergency shutdown like that, you normally need to turn the organ on, let it boot off up completely, and then let it have a normal shutdown where it gets to close everything off properly before it'll be totally back to normal. So the rule is kind of like, yes, you can shut it down with emergency shutdown. But if it really is going completely, next time you turn it on, allow it to go through a switch on and a shutdown cycle properly for it to return itself back to normal. There is also a third way if you really want to, if sometimes the actual OEX program has crashed, and that's because these are Windows computers. And so the other way is you can actually go into Windows and shut down manually from the Windows. And the way you do that is by swiping from the left of the screen. And this is actually, again, it's proving the point of actually having the camera on the screen here. I can slip from the left of the screen there. Can you see that? And it brings up all the programs that Windows has open at the time. And if you want to, you can actually shut them down manually on here. So for the Wersi to work properly, there's actually five programs running there. So you could actually shut them all down, and then you could shut down Windows manually as you would do normally on the Windows computer by hitting there and doing the power switch. So you do have the ability to shut down Windows manually if it has crashed. And just to show you that again, if I swipe from the left, and if anybody's familiar with a Windows computer, this is kind of the standard procedure for seeing all the programs that are open, and then you can close ones that are giving you problems. So if the computer has crashed, it's probably the OAX program that's crashed, not the Windows part. So you can actually shut down the OAX. Windows will still be there, and it then means you can shut down Windows by going for the normal Windows procedure. If you have inadvertently brought that screen up, you're like, I've lost my organ. You can see there's a mini version of the organ up in the top left-hand corner. That's the interface. So you can touch that and you get it back up as normal. So yes, so good question, Neville. That starts us off. Always good to have a question. Let's go back up there. There we go. Thank you, Neville. Johan Zeeland says, good morning, Trevor and Tom. Yeah, well, I will send your regards to Tom on the van. John Senko, it's Neville. It is, if it's allowed. Oh, Neville was trying. Okay, John was answering the question there. John Bradley asks, John, are you enjoying the market? Oh, we're all going to have a chat here now, aren't we? Raymond Sutton says, oh, let's go back. Oh, there's lots of messages on here. It's a busy morning, isn't it? Hi, both. I followed your instructions regarding EQ settings and found my Wersi was not set to the vocalis speakers. I made a change and was amazed at the difference. Thanks a lot. Yeah, so Raymond is alluding to a video that we did on Patreon. So I know we go on about this over and over and over about Patreon, but it's great because we're able to do videos focusing on features and ideas and concepts on all the different organs, and we've started doing some Wersi ones. Now we've got an OAX one back here to use. And the feature that we were talking about was this thing called the EQ, which is on the output mixer. And what's really clever about the Wersi organs, in fact, I could do a clever picture-in-picture there. There we go. There's the output mixer. Is that you've got these two different sets of outputs on the organs, which if you have a Wersi organ that has built-in speakers, they cover the bottom speakers and the top speakers separately. And each one has its own individual EQ. So not only can you change the volume of each set of speakers, you can change the way they're toned. And when you connect external speakers to the organ, like your Wersi Vocalis ones, you can tone the output for those speakers. So how you've got them set up in your room, you can change the EQ without changing the EQ on the organ. And even in the mixer list, you have some presets that allow you to have the Vocalis settings that they recommend that are tweaked towards the Vocalis, but you can change them to your own. And what's really powerful about the Wersi is you can set all these different, lots of different EQ settings for different styles of music. So you may have an EQ setting that you use on pipe organs, an EQ setting that you use on, that camera's gone blank, isn't it? Might have to wake that one up. EQ settings that you use for doing the theatre organ, EQ settings that you use for orchestral, and they can actually be part of your registration even, so that you can change the tone of the organ depending on the style of music that you're playing. So that was a fun video to do. Yes, so Roman, I'm glad you enjoyed that. Adam Robinson, good morning, Trevor and Tom. Hope you're both well. Looking forward to hearing the Wersi organ again. Yes, yes, a lovely sound. It's nice to hear Wersi. It's nice because it's such a contrast to the Lowry organs. A lot of people ask or bring the question up, oh, which one's better? Do you like playing this one or this one? I think this one sounds better. To be honest, I think that all the modern organs sound great. They just sound different. So it's down to your personal preference as to which one you like. And it's always nice to have a change of sound, I think, sometimes. Each instrument has its distinct sound and a distinct feel about it. So it's up to you which one you like. I enjoy playing them all. As you see on the Patreon channel, I enjoy doing my Mature Mondays where I'm playing lots of the older organs as well. Steve Holman, good morning everyone. Yeah, hi Steve. Sue King, hi Trevor and Tom. Can you explain the cutoff control on the ring? Well, I've reduced number from 64 to 35 and the strings sound much softer, which I like. Oh, that's a good question, Sue. What Sue's talking about is using one of the editing features that you have on the Ringway organs. We don't have Ringway here today, but you have a filter. And a filter can be used to remove particular frequencies from a voice. I did a video on this on Patreon a long time ago, explaining about how sounds are made up of lots of different vibrations, and they have like a signature, really, of all the different vibrations that make up that sound. And some of them will be quite deep. You'll have bass vibrations, you'll have mid-range vibrations, and high-pitched vibrations, like you could hear with my voice here. So there's a deep component to it, and there's a mid-range, and there's a high pit, and they all mix together to make my voice. And when you're editing sounds, one of the things that you're able to do, kind of like you do on an EQ, is you can actually take out some of the higher frequencies, or you can add resonance to them or recluse the resonance so they don't get highlighted or they get muted. There's all kinds of ways you can play around with the sound by controlling the frequencies that you hear. And by taking the cutoff, the cutoff frequency is kind of like, all right, I'm not going to let anything higher than this get through. And so when you have sounds that get higher and higher in pitch, you can have it so that the highest part of the sound gets cut off, literally, so you don't hear it. That's part of what you can do with a filter. And so with something like the strings, if you take out the high part, then you will make them more mellow because you're taking out the brightness. And so, yeah, that's one of the things you can do to edit the sounds. Well done, Sue. That's a good thing to do. Where are we up to? So it's good because it's nice hearing Wersi. Yes. Neville's already says, thanks, John. Cheers. Trevor, hi. I'm Trevor, good to see you. The Wersi weekend. Philip Russell, good morning from Hemstead. Wow, we've got a good crowd on today, haven't we? Trevor, can you recommend a rhythm to use for folk songs on the Wersi? Oh, that could be fun to experiment with. Yeah. folk songs. Do you know I don't do many folk songs? I mean, generally folk songs I play will be using a standard kind of 8-beat kind of style. So let me just wake up this camera. I don't know why it's gone to sleep. Maybe it had a busy weekend like me. I think I know why it's not getting any power. Let me just make sure everything is plugged in with it. There we go, that's on there. These are new cameras, actually, so they should all be working absolutely fine. So let's plug that in there. It's a good job it's actually to hand. And in case all this stuff proves that we're being completely live as well. There we go. So that should wake up there. Let me just pop my headphones off. There we go. Let's see if that will produce a little bit of a picture for us now. Come on, camera. There we go. Are you going to let us see what we're doing? No? We're still not going to let us see it. No. Oh. Oh, the joys of technology, eh? Oh, well. so where were we talking about? We were talking about folk music. So folk music, in my mind, you generally tend to hear folk music played with what we call 8-beat styles. What's an 8-beat style? Well, an 8-beat style is one that's based around quavers. So when we talk about music timing, we have the beats of the music, 1, 2, 3, 4. And if you're counting on the beats, then you're talking crotchets as one, lasting one beat. If you divide them up into quavers, you get half beats. So you've got eight quavers to a four beat bar, for example. So one, two, three, four, you go one, then two, and three, and four. So an eight beat rhythm is based around basically quavers. So everything is very regimented and a dun 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 dun. So you tend to hear the hi-hat of the drum pattern playing the counting out the one, then two, and three, and four. And then you hear the bass drum and the snare doing a dum ch dum dum ch. And that generally tends to be the format for most folk music. So we can have a look on here and try some of the eight beat rhythms and see how they sound. And that's part of the fun, I think, is listening to different styles. I don't know if anybody does this at home, but I do a lot of time just listening to the styles on these organs. And see, immediately, like something like that is like a nice laid-back kind of folk kind of backing with a smooth 8-beat. Let's try a standard 8-beat. Let's try 8-beat 3. That's a bit more rock and rolly. See that first one, that the 8-beat one, it's nice. Sometimes it's more down to the way that you kind of play or the sounds that you choose. If you choose more acoustic type instruments, a folk band generally wouldn't tend to have an orchestra with it. So maybe use the guitars. I put that out there actually for any of Wersi owners that are out there. What styles do you use if you're playing on some folk music? It can be a bit fun just trying to think of stuff to play on there. Even sometimes maybe some of the country ones could be maybe a bit folkish. I don't know. Maybe not something like that. maybe not like that. I don't think we have anything in the world ones which are kind of light folky. No. Maybe down in the 8-beat actually, just experimenting with the ones in there in the pop section. And say this, maybe not the fast kind of 8-beats, but those gentle ones. Yeah, that can work quite well. There we go. There we go, a bit of Puff the Magic Dragon. Wasn't expecting to play that this morning. Actually, we have that as a storybook for my child, I bought it for Isaac, actually, a long time ago. I was reading it to Kira recently. And it's quite a sad little story, actually, about Puff the Magic Dragon, because it's all about this boy's friendship with this dragon. And then the boy essentially grows up and stops visiting the dragon. So the dragon gets very, very sad. Until another little girl comes along and he befriends the girl and he has all the fun with the girl. So it's a bit sad, the book in the middle, actually. Ends up all right in the end. Anyway, where are we up to? So we had Denise Masters saying, hi, Trevor. Hi. Hi, Denise. Good to see you. Daniel Barwari. Hello, Pete Sanders. Good morning. Great to finally see the Wersi featured here again. Yes, it's good to have it finally here. Tom McCauley. Good morning from Southport, Merseyside. Hi, Tom. Sukin, you're braver than me, Trevor. I'm not brave. I just get bullied into it. It's very, very difficult to say no to Kira. She's very insistent, especially with me being, you know, the pushover of a dad that I am. Anyway. John Singovich. John, yes. Derek's Pete Brown. Sorry. Good morning. Can you tell me, is it possible to change the position of safe presets in the bank, i.e. swap preset 2 with preset 5? Peter, on the Wersi or on the Lowry? Let me know, Peter. Which organ are we doing that on for swapping presets? Let me know. Derek Sanders, good morning, Trevor. Looking forward to today's show. Hi, Derek. Alvin Tonisti, good morning. It's a great crowd on here this morning. John is saying yes, he immediately loves it. Yes, he's got John Simpson, he's got a wonderful marquee. Neville Jolly, thanks very much, Trevor. Well explained, much appreciated. Well, you're welcome, Jolly. Steve Holm, just before the camera shut down, it said battery was low, so not running on mains power. Well, it's supposed to be, that's the problem. That's why I was checking the cables, because we don't run them off the batteries. But for some reason, all the cables are not providing power to it. So that's going to be something to investigate a little bit later on. One of these is not doing its job properly. And I don't know which one. So anyway, we shall press on regardless. It's a Monday morning, you see. I thought it always was a mistake to choose to do a show on a Monday morning. hi to Tom, Ernie. Yep. John Bradley, your battery's low. Yes. Suking, thanks for explanation. I tried that after watching Lucy's session on the delay on the Larry. She reduced it to 35. Well, delay is a different thing that Sue is a different thing. So that Lucy was using. Lucy was using the delay feature, which we find on the effects section of organs. Delay is a thing that allows you to set up essentially a kind of echo. There are two very similar effects. There's the reverb effect, which is generally all around us, that when you talk or you do any kind of sound, you hear a little bit of after sound, and that's reverberation. It's the vibrations of the sound bouncing off things and coming back to your ears. And generally, when you're in a random environment, you don't hear the sound come back at you. You just hear kind of just an ambient sound that's kind of part of the sound being reflected to you, and that's called reverberation. So we have it on sounds all the time. If we're playing on here, on the Wersi, you hear straight away there's the reverberation. Hear that echoing afterwards. If we go into editing the sounds, you can choose how much of that reverb you have. It sounds like we're in an aircraft hangar. And then you have this other thing, which is called delay. And delay is kind of the technical term for echo. So an echo that we hear in real life, and we do this a lot if I'm with the kids and we drive into an empty car park, we have to get out the car and shout, echo! And generally, because you're in an empty car park, there's nothing to absorb the sound. There's lots of hard concrete, so you hear back, echo, 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 echo. It's the actual whole sound is reflected back to you. So rather than part of the sound coming back to you, the whole sound comes back, which is why you hear echo, rather than just kind of effect. So technically, they call that effect on musical instruments delay, because essentially you're taking the original sound, the hello, delaying it a bit, And then playing it back again, generally at a lower volume, because echoes don't come back as loud as the original one, because a lot of the energy and the sound has already been is taken up and it traveling there and bouncing, hitting the wall and coming back to you. And of course it's going everywhere as well, so you can hear part of it back. So delay kind of delays the original sound, so you hear the original one, and then you hear the same sound being repeated back to you, but it's been delayed, and it's quieter. And then the next one is delayed by the same amount, a bit quieter still, delayed by the same amount, get quieter still, which is what you're hearing here. Yeah. And that's what we call delay. And so you can adjust, Lucy was adjusting three different parameters on that. One is how loud the original sound comes back, how long it takes for it to fade away, and the gap between the echoes, the actual length of the actual delay. And so if you experiment with those numbers, you can get different kind of delays effects. So that's the difference between delay and reverberation. Reverberation is like the ambience. Delay is like an echo where you hear the whole thing coming back at you. And you can have good fun with it. And it's a good way of actually adding some ambience to voices, giving them some character. I think we're putting on the pan pipes and so they sound a bit echoey. It's also a good way if your voices aren't all that good, if you drown them a bit in reverb and delay, it kind of softens them to make them sound better, which is why that effect is used on karaoke machines a lot. So when you hear somebody doing karaoke, it's very echoey. And so when you have a proper singer and you pick up their microphone, it's a very relatively dry sound because they're singing brilliantly. They don't need anything to try and mask it. You pick up the microphone and the karaoke machine, you normally go, hello, 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 everybody, I'm here and singing tonight. I'm going to sing tonight, a song by my... because by putting loads and loads of echo on the voice, it makes it sound better. It's a good way of masking bad singers. Let's catch up on the chat, which is something I would use. So John, everybody's telling me about the mains power. Denise Marshall says, love how you can listen to a style and just know a song that will go with it. Very talented indeed. Well, yes and no. I mean, a lot of that comes from experience. We talked about this on Friday with Lucy when she was saying, somebody asked a question about how do you know how to orchestrate a piece of music. A lot of it is just by listening to music generally and getting a feel for it. I mean, on the Lowry organs, it's very easy because you have lots of what they call signature styles. So they immediately go, oh yeah, you know, I know that song. But part of the fun is kind of experimenting with what songs will go with which and, you know, getting them wrong and getting them right. And because there isn't a definite right or wrong, it's kind of what you enjoy doing. And let's say it's part of the fun. Philip Russell, I need a list of songs that go with what styles. He followed on with that same question. Philip, I can't remember which organ you have, Philip. Let me know. We might have one. Sue King, I like the recommended feature on the task. I suggested 8 stars depending on you play the first few bars. Yeah, that's an interesting feature, actually. They didn't follow that through, did they? Barbara Kefford, hi Trevor, the battery is dead on the camera, that's why it's not working. I know, I know it's the battery, but it's a question of getting power to it, which I don't know why. Derek Sanders says, all that talk about quavers, maybe go and get a packet from the government. Yes, we all like quavers, don't we? Yes. Especially Isaac likes them. Did you notice actually recently they've experimented and they brought out prawn cocktail and salt and vinegar flavour quavers? Just throw that out there. Maybe they might send me a box now, give them a plug. Mark for the about with the don't. Russell, when you are playing, you press some buttons on the left panel. What were those buttons doing? Oh, on the left panel, what was I pressing? Oh, that's a good. What was I pressing over here? Well, the panel over here. Yeah, so I'll tell you what, let's just have a quick check on this camera as to why it's not charging. We've got that in there, that's in there, and that one's in there, and this one's in here. We have to extend the lead to get it to work up here, and it's all plugged in down here, so it is a mystery as to why it's not charging. Oh, now it's suddenly started to come on. So it's at the bottom. Let's see if it'll wake up now. This is a little bit of exciting jeopardy, isn't it? We've added to the video today. Oh, that's a good sound, isn't it? Put that on there. Let me plug this back in here. I'm not very good at doing these things without my glasses. With my glasses on, I have to take them off to see these things. Right, right, we look like we're alive. Hey, right, good. Right. Don't touch it. There we go, brilliant. We got our second camera. So what buttons was I pressing down here? Well, I was using the accompaniment control buttons. So when you choose a style, let's just make it a bit bigger for everybody so you can see that. So on the Wersi's, every style has four variations, three introductions, and two breaks, and synchro start and start stop. So if we choose a style, let's choose one we haven't done yet. Let's try something completely different. I don't know what sweet beat is. Oh, that's nice, isn't it? It's very, very dreamy kind of, yeah. So obviously we start and stop the style down here. And the style itself has four different variations. So you have the first one there, and then you have variation B, variation C, and then when you're playing, you have two different drum breaks. You have drum break number one, and then variation break two. And if you want to on the Wersi, if we go into here, we can actually set up a couple of settings. Auto, what we call an auto fill-in feature. So when you do go between the variations, it will automatically do a drum break. There we go. And of course, when you start the song, you can choose an introduction. You've got introduction one, two, and three. One, nice little count in. And number two is a little bit longer. So one of the very easy ways that you can make any kind of piece of music sound more interesting is to have that development in the style. So rather than the style staying static all the way through a piece of music, you can have it building up. And that's a big part of music, is that you need to go somewhere with a piece of music. So you don't necessarily start off with everything all going. You start with something simple like variation A. And I know somebody now is going to ask, what are you doing with those sliders while you're playing? What are you doing with these drawbars? Well, the drawbars on the Lowry's are, we have normal kind of organ drawbars where you normally a drawbar you see is for controlling different organ sounds. And we do have those kind of drawbars so that we can come up here and have live drawbars. But they also use drawbars for doing the volumes and for controlling volumes and things. So let me move that camera again. You see, what I need is a cameraman. Where's Tom when you need him? There we go. So we can zoom in on this part of the organ now. There we go. We need one of those remote control cameras, don't we? There we go. So you can see them there. So these sliders are controlling all the volume sections of the organ. So I've got this one over here pulled out, which is the general volume. So if I don't have that one turned out, we don't get any sound. And if we go, let's go from left to right. So the one here for song, this is like a general volume for the accompaniment section and for anything that's playing in terms of a song. If I'm playing back a WAV file or a MIDI file, its volume will be controlled by this control here. But it also controls the overall volume of the accompaniment. So when you have an accompaniment playing, let's choose a different one. Let's do swing it. So you have the drums there. Your bass player. And then all the accompaniment parts. So you can kind of balance between the two. You can just have the bass player with his guitar. Thing. So yes, so that's what the volumes are doing there for the accompaniment. And then on the Wersi organ, you can mix many, many sounds together in the right hand and the left hand. We've talked about this before. You can mix up to, you can have up to 16 different voices playing simultaneously. But they didn't have room to have 16 different drawbars for the upper keyboard. So they gave us drawbars for the first three voices, which actually is fine. And most of the registrations, you're maybe going to mix three sounds together. So maybe if we've got a piano in there, and let's be completely unoriginal, put some strings with it, into the strings orchestra. What should we do? We've got so many strings to choose from. And this actually is another tip. You know, a lot of people, they rarely just try sounds out. I really should recommend that people spend time trying voices rather than just choosing one. Sitting down and actually getting this screen up here and trying the strings out. So if we get the hold on, I can go for these strings. And just listen to them all. Hollywood string. You can hear how they're all so different. So say like the string sustain there. I've put that on voice number two. So I can blend with these drawbars. See the. And of course, I can take a third voice and bring that in there and maybe put some choirs in there. Let's see, yeah, put a choir in there. And again, that's now on the third drawbar, so I can use that to blend it together. Or, for example, we were doing a bit of a band. We could go back and have a little section going where we have a clarinet player. That's good clarinet, isn't it? And then we can come to the second voice and maybe have a saxophone player. So we've got a clarinet. And maybe they could be joined by, say, a trumpet player. Wait a minute, I changed the first one there. I lost my saxophone. Let's put the saxophone back there. Now we go to the third one and find the trumpet sound. Trumpet, saxophone, clarinet, and there you go. So you can use these as a way of highlighting a voice while you're playing without necessarily cancelling out the other sounds. A lot of the time on organs we get rid of everything else in favour of the solo player. Well, sometimes it could be quite nice just to highlight the solo player and rather than turning these ones off completely, just turn them down a bit. There we go. So that's what we're doing with the drawbars there. And then in the middle, we've got the same things for the lower manual as well. Let's catch up with the chat. How are we doing? We got as far as... David Woods. Hi, Trevor. I'm in Southport, Merseyside, and have the Wersi OAX Duo Pro. Nice to hear the OAX one. Yeah, so the Abacus was the previous generation of... of Wersi organs, and the Duo was the version that had the lower keyboard. So, on all the Wersi single keyboard models, you have the option of adding a lower keyboard to them. And so, obviously, they did a lot of development between the Abacus and this system, the OAX system, in terms of usability. So we have this wonderful touchscreen where we can drag things around and move them around. It's all good fun. Sukin says you're going to try changing the delay. Yes. Ernie says hi from hi Ernie. Graham Edwards, my problem with styles is trying to play in the way that matches the intro or ending, otherwise it just sounds like a different tune, or the he pressed the automatic ending button. Yeah, it's an interesting thing with endings and styles and introductions, and we talk about a lot of this in the store sometimes. It is trying to find the styles so it doesn't sound like it's so regimented. And, you know, there is this whole thing that, yeah, you press introduction, it does its introduction, you play your bit in the middle, and then you press ending. And there is a feeling sometimes on these organs where the endings and the introductions kind of like overshadow the bit in the middle when you're actually playing, because they're so clever and doing so much. The answer to that sometimes is to maybe find styles which, or use the endings and introductions aren't quite so grand, funnily enough. You know, that's why manufacturers give us a choice of introductions. On the Lowry's, we have a lot of signature styles, so the style, the introduction and the ending feels like part of the song. But certainly on here, you know, when I was playing with that little bit of a jazz thing there, if I just wanted the simple introduction... See, I could have just used introduction number one there and it would have just counted itself in there. Do you hear that? And also, there's an element where you don't necessarily always have to use an introduction. I know we feel obsessed with using them, but you can... And there's also a trick that I always kind of use with all these kind of endings, especially with the endings, is that sometimes you do feel that you're kind of like pressing the ending button and that's the end of your involvement. And so you play a piece of music, you're playing there. Yeah, isn't that great? Everybody enjoyed that? Let's put the ending button. Thank you. Now, there is a kind of an issue with that because, yes, it feels like, you know, your involvement in the piece of music has finished kind of too early because you're allowing the instrument to finish the piece of music. Now, we have done on Patreon again, lots and lots of videos where we talk about maybe doing your own style of ending, how to come up with your own ending rather than always using the ending button on the instrument. But there's also a thing that even if you are using the ending button on the instrument, try and play along with the ending so that rather than it being just you pressing a button and folding your hands and watching it, because it's not much fun for yourself because, you know, you're just listening to the same ending every time. And also anybody's listening, unfortunately, it kind of gives them the impression that you weren't really playing in the first place because, you know, you press a button and sit back and it all carries on anyway. So they kind of feel suspicious that you were doing a bit in the middle. And also you do have that kind of feeling that when you press the ending button, it sounds better than what we were doing in the middle anyway. So it's nice to try and play along a little bit with the ending. And you don't have to be a fantastic musician or you don't have to do a lot for it to feel like you're involved with it. So the first thing is to remember that even on these endings, when you hear them, that's probably not a good example. Let's find one that does a bit more to the ending. Oh, let's find one that's... Oh, there we go. That's good, isn't it? A bit of big band boogie. I like that. It's kind of doing the... So on that particular ending, when you press the ending, let's have a listen to it. Now you can hear that it's playing quite a lot of music there. It's not just sitting there and going. It's going off and doing all this thing. Now, a lot of people say, well, I can't work out what that's doing. I can't play by ear. I'm going to sit here spending ages trying to work out what note it's doing and all those kind of things. You don't really, if you want to try and play along with the ending, because you know that it's going to be doing stuff that's still musical and it's stuff that still fits in with what you played. And so even if the ending goes off and does a lot of clever things or does funny notes or stuff that you don't recognize or you think, I can't work that out by ear, it will always come back to your last chord. Whatever happens, it's got to finish the piece of music on the chord that you finished on. There are a few weird ones, and I managed to find one that doesn't do that just to make you leave you hanging. But generally, 99 times out of 100, if you press the ending button, it may go off on a chord progression and do different chords and play nice little clever bits, but it will always come back to the notes that, or the chord that you finished on. So if I finish on the chord of C, you can bet that it will go off and do its clever thing, but it will finish off. Back to C. So even without knowing much about the ending and all the musicality that was going on there, I could still take part and do the last part of it. And this goes back to what I was saying earlier about listening to styles. Listen to the ending so you know what it's going to do. And when you're doing that, slow it right down. So you can actually... You hear it back? And if you get in that last chord there, anybody watching feels that actually, oh, it was you that did it. You've the one that finished it off. You got the last word in. And also it's nice for you because you actually are kind of playing along with that and you feel like you've actually been the one that's helped finish the piece of music. So listen to the styles slowly if you need to. And in fact, when you listen to them very slowly, like that, do that again. da. You can almost work out what's going on it. So, have a play with that. And on any kind of instrument, that can really make a big difference. But it's a Yamaha Wersi Lowry. Playing along with the ending can be a fun thing to do. Ah, that was a long answer, wasn't it? Sorry. Peter Steen says, good morning, sorry I'm late. Okay, Peter, that's okay. Well, I'm late catching up with the chat. Roger Burton says, just got here. Hi, Trevor. Hi, Roger. Peter Brown, preset position swap on the Wersi, saved set of positions, put one, saved another set, put two. Would you like to get them to follow in sequence? Well, the easiest way to move presets around is just to literally resave them, to be honest. Let's get our screen, reset our camera onto the screen here. There we go. Get around here, if I can sit back down again. I'm doing very, very well today without tripping over all the wires and things. There we go. So on this particular organ, this is brand new out of the box, this keyboard, so I haven't even set up where I want my split points and things, but we can save presets. Let's just save something in here, the total preset bank, let's put something number one. I mean, literally, if I've saved it in the wrong place, down there, the easiest way really is to just literally resave it into a new place. and if I've stored, oh, let's just keep that screen up there, let's just get that up there so you can see it. There we go. So if I've stored something in bank number one and I need it to be in number five, all I would do normally is choose that registration and then move it, resave it, just go back and save that in space number five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there we go. So I've got it in five now. And then what I had in the other one, I would then resave back over. So I wouldn't worry so much about copying and swapping them. I would just resave them in the places where I would want them to be, if that makes sense. And I would do that the same on any organ, on the Lowry, on the Yamahas. Is you can't really swap registrations around, but once you've got a registration selected, you can resave it in the place that you want it to go, which is almost like copying and pasting, where you're using the panel, as it were, for the place where you copy and paste to and from. That sounds a bit technical, doesn't it? Roger Marshall, morning gents, actually catching you live. Well done, Roger. Peter Canton, sounds very nice, Trevor. Thank you, Peter. Sue King, she likes the sound. Thank you, Sue. Sue King asks, can you take parts of the style in and out? And how would you control 4 to 16 volumes on the screen? Play the last files of the songs and introduction instead of the automatics. Yes, that's one of the tips we mentioned actually in the Patreon video. Play notes in the chord over the ending, yes. Though you have to be careful with that, so as I said, because the endings a lot of the time go off and do chord progressions. So it won't mean necessarily playing the chord that you finished on. But it will come back to it. That's the point. Even if it goes off and does a chord progression, it will come back to your original chord. And that's the point where you can join in, as Sue says, playing just the notes of the chord. And again, one of the tricks that we spoke about on one of our Patreon channels about when you want to improvise an ending is to use the sixth note as a way of just adding your own twiddly bits. Let's just catch up on the chat, then we go back to answer the questions about that Sue had. Denise Masters says, don't worry about anyone thinking I'm playing all my mistakes, let's know how. Yes. Sue King, OTS feature, one touch settings. Yep, John Sinkovich, sounds like a steam engine starting out neat. Sue King, chatting with your choo-choo, yes. Sue's question, let me get another swig. So Sue had a question that we were talking about on the Wersi organs, how wonderful they are because we can mix 16 different voices together. That is a bit tricky because obviously we only have these first three volume controls here on the panel. So as Sue just said, what we do when we go beyond that is we can use the screen, and let me whack up a little there. So now on the upper manual here, we actually have now 8 different voices all selected. I haven't got sounds in all of them. But when you, underneath each one of them, I don't know if you can see, there's a green bar. So when I touch one of the boxes, I have a volume control here that allows me to adjust the volume, which is then displayed as part of that green bar. So each one, yes, I can go along and set the volumes individually. And if we double tap a sound, we can then see all its settings. And one of the nice things on the Wersi's, this is introduced on the upgrades, is that this is upper manual voice one, which I don't know if you remember, we set as being a clarinet. So we can see all the settings for that voice, the octave settings, so I can take my clarinet down an octave. I can change its reverb, I can pan it more to the left and right. I even add a bit of delay, I can change, edit the sound. When I finish doing that one, rather than having to go back to the main screen, I can just swipe like that. And now I'm on the second voice, which was my saxophone. I can maybe pan that to the other side. Clarinet one side, saxophone the other. Add a reverb, mess around with it a bit. Maybe take that down an octave. So I can actually swipe through each one of the voices there. And there we go. How many do we have on that? I think I only had three voices on the end, yeah. So if I put a sound in the fourth one, I could scroll to the sound in the fourth one. So if a bit of viola in there and I'm playing on that one, I can go along to number two and then number three as well. So all of the voices I can go through, let's just touch it, there we go, and edit the sounds and edit the volume controls on there. I think also what you could do, if you're being really technical, let's have a look, where is it on here? Assignable drawbars is we could actually, couldn't that be useful doing it on there? Yeah. So yeah, so I was just checking something before I said that we could do it. we said on the Wersi organ, we have all these volume controls over here, but we also have drawbars over here. But the drawbars are also what they call assignable controllers, which means if you don't want to use them as drawbars, you can actually set up all these drawbars to be all your volume controls for all the 16 different parts. So if you had 16 different parts playing, you could actually put them all on the drawbars here if you wanted to. That's just one of the options that you have. So you could, rather than, if you're not using the drawbars to be organ sounds, you could use them to be all the volume controls. So they call them assignable controls, and they are numbered from 1 to 16, so you could actually use those instead. She also asked, can you take parts in and out the style? Yes, we can. So if we have a style playing, look at the screen again. You can go into the mixer part of the style there, and you can see all this wonderful screen where you see everything that's going on. And of course, you could mute different parts. Or you can actually solo a separate part, so you can just. Brass section there, bring them all back. So yes, you can take parts in and out. If you wanted to be really high tech, you can actually go into a full style editor and then you can actually edit the actual sounds that are being used within the style. So you can even change the drum kits and do all kinds of clever things to it. But on a very kind of surface level, you can take parts in and out, and you can also of course remix them in more detail as well on the screen there. So yes, in answer to Sue's question. Does the Wersi have its feature, OTS feature? Yes. So, good set of questions, Sue. So the Wersi's have, they call them sound to styles. So all manufacturers nowadays have a feature whereby if you choose a style, let's put on something, I don't know, let's do something we haven't done yet. Oh, what should we choose? Broadway, for example. When you choose a particular style, it will have registrations that have been already set up for that style that give you a quick way of being able to play. Mainly on the Wersi's, you choose them at the bottom of the screen here. It says S to S, sound to style, or style to stand. And each one gives us a different registration to go with that style. Funnily enough, on the OX one, we have them up here as buttons as well. So, so we can just play a piece of music. Go back here. That's better. Let's have an introduction. And there's a good example there. See, that style went off and did all kinds of funny things. But I was still able to get the last word in because I knew it was going to come back and finish on the C. Just to prove that wasn't a fluke, let's choose a different style completely. Say a country. And the sounds of styles will be completely different. Doing its own thing, and then back. So I can get the last word in there. So there you go, we're caught up with everybody. So Suking, oh yes, Vichy, John, it sounds like a steam engine riddle. That's a, wow, I finally caught up with the chat. Wow, amazing, thank you. Well, it's been good fun today. I've really enjoyed it. Some great questions coming in there, a nice crowd of people as well. So it's been a lot of fun. It's nice to be back here with a Wersi OAX and exploring all the different ideas and the sort of the possibilities that the OAX system gives you. And apologise for our little technical issues with the cameras. That's our little Monday morning gremlin. But it's been good fun today. I shall just ask very quickly if there's any last minute burning questions that anybody has. How do I sign up for Patreon? How do I order my new Wersi keyboard? Any of those kind of things, just feel free to chuck them in now before I play my closing number. I shall give you a few moments while I have a quick browse through here and see what style the Schlager beat sounds. So this is the part of the fun, it's just nice going through different styles. And just think, getting inspiration from styles. I mean, it's great fun. It's like a Schlager rumba. Oh, that's nice. Yeah, we might finish with that. So let's find a bit of sound to style. Yeah, that kind of works. So, if there's no more questions, it's all been quiet, yes. Thanks for very informative. And hi, Steve, yes. Pete Sanders, thank you. So I'm glad you enjoyed it. I shall play my final number. But if you had anything you want us to cover in videos in the future, just email the questions in, or you can give us a call in the store, and we will be back with Lucy on Friday at 3 o'clock for her Lowry session. We have lots of fun with Lucy on Fridays. And myself and Tom will hopefully be back together next Monday, and I think we will stick with the Wersi because we need to catch up with the Wersis. And so in this time, in that week, you've got, think of some questions to throw in to us when we've got both myself and Tom here, and we'll do our best to answer them. So thank you very much for your company today. Glad you enjoyed it, and we shall finish with a little bit of a Schlager rumba. That sounds a lot of fun, doesn't it? Let's see what introduction we shall have. Oh, that's a bit short. Let's have a long one. There we go. See you later.